Okay, hi. Long time, but hey. What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Mary Shannon, and I have been gone again for the third time now, where I kept saying I'm gonna be more regular about this, and then I stopped vlogging, and I was like, okay, well, maybe I can still consistently post writing videos once a month. And then I haven't done that for 3 months, and I've neglected this completely, and I've done nothing. And oh my god, I'm just back with an iPhone camera now, so I apologize if the quality has significantly diminished, but my Canon G7X Mark II it's kind of started shitting the bed, so this is the best that I got right now. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna start filming again, and please excuse my appearance. I just got home from work and scarfed down a bunch of Indian food, and I'm also now wearing the same depression t-shirt for the third day in a row. So as you can tell, the reason why I'm back to filming is because I'm sad again. Okay, the goal today is to not cry. We are not going to cry today, Mary Shannon McHugh. We're gonna man up. We're gonna be tough. We have no tears. No tears. Okay, so in my shower this morning, I had spent the entire time losing my shit and crying because I had a dream in which me and my boyfriend were making out and we were still together, and I woke up and I said, wow, what a lovely dream about my boyfriend. And I said, oh wait, I don't have one of those anymore, and it hurts. So that was bad, and so I cried a lot, but right now my skin is very tight and also very clear from all the salt from my tears, so that's a positive. Hopefully today I won't lose my mind at work.
Guess who cried like a little psycho in front of her boss just now? This bitch, this psycho. I couldn't hold it in. I did a good job yesterday, but today? We took the L, baby. We took the L today.
Which is the reason why I started filming in the first place, and the reason why I stopped filming or really neglected this YouTube channel in general, is because life was going pretty good. I had moved out. I live in Manhattan. I had gotten a job pretty quickly. Let's see, I moved here in July and got hired full time, an actual career, big girl job, by October. And, you know, I was meeting new people, I was making friends, and the best part was, I had gotten into my first ever big girl relationship, an actual, boyfriend-girlfriend relationship for the first time at 25. And, that ended a week ago, just shy of 6 months, which continues my curse of never being in a fling or a semi-relationship or whatever for longer than 6 months. And I'm doing better than I was a week ago when this happened, especially all of last week. So let's see, I got dumped on July 5th, which is like exactly 1 month into 25, which, sorry, excuse me, felt great. Good start, off to a great start this year. So happy to be alive. I literally have a picture of us right here because I'm pathetic and I keep looking at it because I'm so fucking sad. Fuck.
My youth all grow up next summer. I'm back on Instagram's after I have my dealer's number. I'm still young, wasting my youth. I'll grow up next summer. I'm back on Instagram's
after. I don't know the words.
I just think like the hardest part about this whole breakup process, especially at 25, is like at this point my brain is fully online and developed, so I'm trying to be very rational about everything, but then also at the same time I feel like I'm 16 years old, and this is the worst thing that has ever happened to me, and I simply want to, not necessarily no longer exist, but I want to, maybe, like, punch a wall, or, like, steal from Rite Aid. Like, that would make me feel better. So I'm kind of combating those two sides of my brain right now, and really, I think I just have to finally listen to the new Olivia Rodrigo album.
Ah, I'm okay. I'm okay. I'm gonna be okay. I'm sexy, I'm cool, I'm smart, I'm hot. Any other time except for right now. But yeah, Monday was bad, and then Tuesday was also pretty bad, and then Wednesday I did the worst thing you can do as an adult, which is cry in front of your boss. She was great about it, and then I cried in front of the rest of my coworkers, and then they were all great about it. Everyone was so good. I work with all women, so really, like, it's okay. But as it was happening, I felt, wow, what a great cathartic release that I don't have to keep holding this down at work. I don't know if that was worth it though, because the absolute sense of embarrassment I felt for the rest of the day definitely suppressed any sad feelings I had, because truly I was mortified to what I've done to these women who are almost, you know, like 5-10 years older than me. So that was fun, exciting, so quirky of me that happened. Also, something super quirky that happened to me is I finally cried on the train for the first time, so I can knock that off my New York City bucket list. Because I forgot to mention, on Tuesday, which was the day after I got broken up with, I held it all day at work. Did a great job, excellent chef's kiss performance for Mary, and by that I mean I was solid like a statue, gave non-responses all day, and barely spoke to anyone, which is cool of me. So I held it in all day, and then I immediately, as soon as I got onto my train, I listened to Halsey's latest album and then fucking sobbed like a crazy person the entire train ride home. So that was cool. By the time I got off the train, I looked like fucking Bucky Barnes, but like in the least sexiest way possible, in the most like PTSD way possible, I look like Bucky Barnes, so that was cool. So yeah, that was Tuesday. Wednesday, cried in front of my boss and my coworkers. Thursday, I read an entire book. I haven't read a book since potentially 2017. 2018 would be bold, but I'm pretty sure 2017. So that was the first time I read a whole book in a day, and I was like, oh look, like maybe I can make reading my thing. And then I accidentally read the whole book in a day instead of pacing it out, and then I cried again to school. So update. I didn't cry today, which is nice. But it's raining really bad, and I think I'm just really sad right now. But that, like, kind of sad where you just don't really have much left to give. I want to cry, because every time I cry, I feel better, and I get, like, a little manic high, and I feel happy. Happy. but, oh, this is such a bad angle. I look so nasty. Welcome to Ugly Girl Hours, as I say. Fuck. I want to cry, but I can't. I'm tapped out, which kind of sucks. Cause, like, I feel like I'm just, like, blue-balling my own emotions right now. Where, like, I want a nut. I want to cry, because then I'll have, like, post-nut, post-cry clarity. But I can't. I can't nut. Can't cry. So I'm just stuck in this weird emotional edging. Dude, I wish I was, like, 21 again, and, like, fucking insane, and my brain wasn't fully online yet like it is now, and I could just, like, be psycho and, like, do some psycho shit. But no, I feel myself being mature, and I hate that. I think I hate that. I don't like the fucking What's this? I don't like Captain Hook. Friday, I got margaritas after work with two of my coworkers, and we talked about just girly things and how I'm gonna be a girl boss again, which felt great. But then I got home and I was good, and then I got sad again. So it was great. It was a good time. And then Saturday, it was decent all day, and then I waited for my my roommate, my best friend Anthony's girlfriend, to leave, and then I got ridiculously zooted. Guess who's stoned out of her mind? Ooh! The amount of edibles I consumed was truly unhinged on my part, but I definitely reached a state of euphoria through listening to Machine Gun Kelly's album, and then I followed it with Melodrama by Lorde, and then I followed it with Folklore by Taylor Swift, and I came to some grand conclusions that I will potentially share with you, given how this coming weekend will go, because in my state of being truly zooted to the fucking moon, I finally texted my ex-boyfriend, asking him to have, I don't know, potentially a final talk. I say potentially because who knows? I don't know. To kind of give you an idea, Monday, when he broke up with me, I was not the best in character, because it really did blindside me pretty hard, and I didn't want to say I yelled, but I definitely begged and was certainly just not in my character, and it was really just not a good moment and not a way I want to potentially leave my first ever relationship, because unfortunately to the man I dated, he dated a gay person, and we can't let shit go easily. So hence why after I left, we haven't spoken for a couple days, and then I texted him asking if we can at least meet up this coming weekend and just talk. We'll see how it goes. The thing is, I have accepted both paths it can go, and that's how I know I'm ready to talk, because however the conversation ends, I'll be okay. And either the path is we figure something out or we don't. And I don't want to speak too much on that now, so I'll give an update this coming weekend about all of that. But between that and some past trauma that has come up from the beginning, I don't want to phrase this, fuck. So also on top of that, some past trauma that I experienced last year around the same time has bubbled up again this year, in which I thought I had suppressed it, and in, I don't know, you think I would fucking learn by now, but I have not, because I'm dumb as fuck. Is anytime I think I suppress something, even if I forget it mentally, the body will always remember it physically. And which caused me to have a couple of bad anxiety attacks at the beginning of this month, which were not great. And maybe I'll feel more comfortable to speak about that soon, but I just I just don't right now. But maybe I'll get to, and I think that's all I have for updates right now. I might also, I think that's all I have right now. I'm in a weird state of sadness where I'm just very calm right now, and I'm just waiting to have this final talk, or potentially final talk. And then I'm gonna go from there, and I'll update you guys from there. Fuck has been the theme. Fuck, and everything fucking sucks.
Hello, welcome to Nighttime Ugly Girl Hours. I'm your host, Mary Shannon McHugh, and this is my co-host, Mr. Ralph Lauren. Saturday night, gonna go to bed soon. Today was a pretty good day, did a little bit of socializing. Marie Kondo'd like my whole closet, basically, to make room for all my new hoe clothes that are coming in the mail. And I threw out a bunch of other stuff and kept busy and ate almost an entire pint of Ben and Jerry's for dinner. I'm not excited for tomorrow. It's like having this whole talk thing is my idea in the first place. I'm the one who initiated all of this, and I want to do it. But a part of me just really wants to control alt delete this person out of my life and block them on all social media and pretend that nothing ever happened, because
that's how I used to deal with things in the past, and it felt good in the moment, bad over time, but good in the moment. I want to be toxic, but also I know I need to grow up and do this tomorrow, and as much as I don't want to, I have to, because if I don't do it tomorrow, it won't ever happen, and so it just has to happen. And I just feel like I'm probably going to monologue for a really long time at this poor man, and I feel awful that I'm going to take up a few hours on a Sunday to just speak my truth. I don't know. Like, I keep telling everyone who asks me, well, not everyone, because I still haven't really told a lot of people yet, that we broke up, but, everyone keeps telling me, I was like, well, how do you hope it ends tomorrow? And then the thing is like, I know how I want it to begin, and I know the middle, and I have a general outline of how I would like the conversation to go, but ultimately I don't know the ending, which is really funny, because when I come to any writing project, anything I do, whether it's a poem, a short story, something long, whatever, I don't write it unless I know the ending, because I need to know where it's gonna stop or else I'll never get there. But yeah, I don't know how tomorrow's gonna end, but I keep telling everyone I've like Doctor Strange myself into the fact that I have seen every outcome, or I see every outcome, and I have accepted every outcome. So whatever happens tomorrow is fine. It'll be fine. It better be fine, because I also this week bought this expensive ass Libyan Desert Class. For what? To feel something. To feel hope. To feel hope. It'll be fine, Mary. It's gonna be fine. It's gonna be fine. Good night. Okay, so my ex will be here in about an hour for a little chit chat. Personally, I kind of just want to throw up right now for my nerves, or also because I only have a large oat milk latte from Dunkin' Donuts in my stomach and absolutely no human people food yet, and it's like 2 p.m. and that could also be the reason why I want to throw up. I think both are valid. Both things can be true. Either way, I just want to throw up it all. So I want to throw it all up. I want it out. I don't know what it is, but I want it gone.
It's really over. God, I'm so fucking sad.
Is gonna be the end of this vlog, ending on some ugly girl hours, but also most importantly, today is July 20th, which in my mind officially marks 1 year of me living in New York City. Because July 20th last year was the first night I slept in this little rat hole of a bedroom and never went back home. yeah, and I don't know, I've been obviously in a very reflective mood recently, especially just sparked by this whole breakup that I'm going through. Or I guess really shouldn't say going through anymore, because it's very much over. Me and my ex-boyfriend had our final talk on Sunday, which was 2 days ago. And honestly, it went the best possible way in my mind it could have gone. And I think everyone's going to be better for it in the end, even though it still kind of sucks right now. And I am really sad, but I'm sad just because, you know, it's over, and I very notoriously hate endings. In fact, I have not finished so many TV shows only because I have one episode left and I just don't want it to end. I get sad when things are done, which is maybe also why I can't ever fucking finish anything I write. But yeah, no, the breakup went the best possible way it could have gone, and I'm really okay and very calm about everything that had happened, because for the first time in any sort of like breakup scenario that I've been in, this was the first time that I was able to say everything that I wanted to say, and I wasn't embarrassed. I didn't feel like I had to hide my feelings or make myself small to make the other person more comfortable. I just said my piece and I let all of it go, and yeah, I mean, it ended on, like I said, the best terms it could have ended, and you know, hopefully down the line I think we could probably be friends, but that's not gonna be for like months or anything like that anytime soon, because now I really just want to be on my hot girl shit. I think I want to cut all of this fucking hair off finally, and I have a whole new wardrobe coming in the mail here probably next week, so I'm gonna be back on, you know, doing my real hot girl shit, which is exciting. But yeah, as I was saying, it's been 1 year of me living here, and you know, I had a couple of losses, but I had a lot of fucking wins. A lot of wins. And as shitty as things still kind of feel right now, I've been having better days. I've been having more good days, and I'll take it. Because there's only more good days to come. I hope. At least that's what the pattern app says, and that's what I'm gonna fucking go by. Yeah, I'm trying to think if I have any other notes. Yeah, I definitely want to try vlogging again, but I, like I said, I think they're gonna be pretty shit, and I don't think I'm gonna advertise, like I'm not gonna post on Instagram and Twitter like, oh, new video, please like, comment, and subscribe, blah blah blah, like, eh. I don't know, I'm over that. I think I just want to keep this channel private, right? Just post whenever I want to post, not feel obligated, and just document my second year here. The first year fucking flew by, but now that I have a pace and a rhythm again, and honestly when I'm not in a relationship, I do much better at focusing on my creativity, and hopefully in the next partnerships that I have, I'm able to find balance between, you know, being in love and being a writer. But yeah, I'm gonna try vlogging again and post my dumb little thoughts and adventures here, but like I said, just keep it private, and yeah, I don't know, I don't have very many thoughts. I've also been up since 5 a.m. and I have to go to work and go to bed soon, or no, I have to go to bed soon because I have to go to work in the morning or something. I'm so tired and I think the melatonin is hitting. Anyways, I'm going to be happy soon, eventually. I will be. I always have been. If there's anything I will pride myself on, is I always figure it out. Always. I've never not figured it out, so that's certainly not gonna stop now just because I'm a little heartbroken. So yeah, other than that, I hope you have a good rest of your day or night or wherever this video finds you, and I will catch you next time, okay? Okay, bye.
I have successfully had zero sad thoughts today. What a beautiful, wonderful day in the neighborhood.